Outside of the U.S. steel plant here in Granite City, leaders with the United Steelworkers Union say if members do authorize a strike, it does not necessarily mean that a walkout will happen right away, but it does give the union permission to call a strike on behalf of its members if negotiations with U.S. Steel break down. We can show you some video from inside the mill here. We understand about 1,200 workers are impacted locally in three different unions. We're told the collective bargaining contracts expired on September 1st, but were extended as the talks continue. U.S. Steel officials say they do not anticipate a strike and that talks are ongoing. A spokesperson saying that plants continue to operate in a safe and orderly fashion. These labor issues come as the situation at the Granite City Works here seemed to be looking up after some very tough times. Steel tariffs imposed by President Trump led to the company restarting both blast furnaces here and some 800 workers being called back. The president even visited the plant here back in July. All of that came after massive layoffs during a downturn in the steel industry. By the end of 2015, both blast furnaces here were idled and some 1,500 workers were either laid off or left from attrition. Union leaders say the last time steel workers here in Granite City authorized a strike was back in 1993. That was when the facility was under different ownership. Lisa and John, we understand there are four different meetings today at the local unions to take this potential strike vote. We will see what unfolds as this vote goes down here and across the country. For now, live in Granite City, Chris Fournier, Fox